Honorable ex-Chief Justice of India, K.G. Balakrishna Dal, other dignitaries, Dr. Shidla ji, thank you very much for sacrificing this time. Your topic, Challenges of Indian Democracy, is very vast. And certainly, Dr. Ambedkar is the most important and really most relevant person whose thoughts are relevant and meaningful for this discussion. This discussion needs a lot of time, but I have to summarize Dr. Ambedkar's thoughts and the real problems. Really, the thoughts of Dr. Ambedkar about social and economic democracy are very meaningful. Whenever we talk about the challenges before our Indian democracy, we talk about political democracy also. Dr. Ambedkar told that political democracy is futile. If social and economic democracy is not there, his views were supported by other great men also. Nobel laureate Amar Sen also concluded that in economics, Amar Sen is my, Dr. Ambedkar is my father. He told like that. He also said that without social development and economic development, market cannot develop. In the same way, recently Abhijit Banerjee won Nobel Peace Prize. He also said that the rich must be taxed more. He also reiterated the same thing as Dr. B.R. Ambedkar said. What is the problem of Indian democracy? Indian democracy is successful, no doubt, but so many problems are there which must be addressed properly. They could not be addressed properly and very well because the caste exists here. When World Bank Chairman Jim Yong King came here in Vibrant Summit, he also felt like this, that without annihilation of caste, you cannot develop. Recently, another book has been written, The Doctor and the Saint by Arundhati Roy. She also said, if you want to annihilate caste, you can't. If you do not go through Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, whether it is possible inside class or outside class, you will have to go to Dr. Ambedkar's thoughts. Dr. Ambedkar wrote Annihilation of Caste. Certainly, there is no law against caste or strife. We talk about law against untouchability. We have enacted law against prevention of SCST Act, Atrocity Act. But there is not yet any law against caste. Law against caste means there should be no surname, no name, no discussion about caste except at academic fora and positive affirmation facilities, affirmative action. Only in those cases that must be allowed. What is happening? That people are strengthening their caste. That is a great hazard that is very destructive to the existence of democracy. All the people who are victims of caste, they are also not taking interest about demanding any law against caste. The best solution is, if parliament enacts a law against caste, certainly the democracy will be more successful and the citizens of India will be happier. We have parliamentary democracy, but nowadays a great challenge is there. The parliament has become a recommendatory body. Every law is challenged, and what happens? Every second day, some judicial review takes place. What suffers? Indian democracy and parliamentary democracy suffers a lot. People lose their belief in parliamentary traditions, which is destructive from the point of view of democracy. Election Commission of India certainly has been a subject of question mark in every elections. Some chairmen, some people, some chief election commissioners were exemplary. They did exemplary job. But the performance of others were questioned. What is needed in Election Commission? Election Commission of India is the protector of democracy. If the pulse of the people says that this kind of method should be adopted to strengthen democracy, it should take it very seriously. But as yet, it has not been done. Election Commission of India is concerned. We should include at least one High Court retired judge and a member, a representative of opposition parties also. If Election Commission is not strengthened, opposition cannot be strengthened. What is happening? In society, the fear factor is taking place. If our citizens are afraid of one another, certainly democracy is not successful. Somewhere SCST atrocities, somewhere mob lynching is taking place. Democracy is suffering. It's a question mark upon democracy. We are fighting for a fearless society. We have innovated democracy for this. And especially the danger for democracy is the representation. For 1 or 2 minutes, I would like to please excuse me for that. Why democracy is suffering? It is based upon that our representation system is not good. We are not represented well. We claim that India is the largest democracy. But what is happening? In England, there is population of 5.5 crores. They are represented by 1,500 people. In USA, 41.5 crore. They are represented by 535 MPs. In China, 2,987 MPs are there. And population is 140 crores. If our constituencies are larger, the value of our vote decreases. If we want to value our vote properly, we need smaller constituencies. If 2,500 constituencies are there in India, adequate representation of people will take place. Jiski jitni sankhya bhari, utni uski hissedari. Some people are, I'm sorry if you permit for 2 or 3 minutes. Is it possible? Some people are defaming reservation system, but okay. Hero worship is the greatest danger. Okay, hero worship, what is taking place in Indian democracy, hero worship is there. And people are defaming quota system. But it has happened by a survey conducted by Thomas Tushas and Dr. Ashwini Deshpande, that the people who have come through quota or reservation safeguards, they have worked in a better manner, an improved manner. So that theory has failed already. I'm sorry, because this topic is very vast. So justice cannot be done. So thank you very much, Dr. Sheetla Saab. Thank you very much. Thank you, sir.